Okay, before we go to the control chart, let me revisit the variations based on the sample. So here you see the two different types of variations. One is the common variations. This common variation is basically present in the every process. So if there is a common variation present, the output of the process, as you see here, the forms the distribution that is the stable over the time and is predictable. Stable process simply means it's a predictable process. But when there is assignable variation are present, the process output is not stable over time. So we are not able to predict the pattern of the process. Somehow it needs to be corrected and get back to the normal process. So in terms of types of sampling, so we are talking about control chart, but before going to moving into control chart, we need to know the two different types of sampling. One is the attribute measure, and usually samples are classified as either conforming or not conforming to the specification limit. So our conclusion only would be good or bad or function or malfunction. For like a low monomer case, we conclude based on the our sample, we can only conclude run or do not run, doesn't run. There's no other way to conclude this. Use the p-chart using the sample proportion, which is not the case of this course, but we will focus on variable measures we call continuous measure. This process includes the mean and standard deviation because it measures actual weight or speed or length and so on. So for example, low monomer's case, actually low monomer's torch and horsepowers can be measured as an amount of deviation from the set standard. So in this variable measures, we use the two. One is mean, which is X bar, and R, which is range chart. So I will explain these two. Okay, we will use the control chart for variable continuous measures measured by mean and standard deviation. Always two control charts are used. One is X bar chart, which are to control the central tendency of the process. So mean, sample mean, and R chart. R is indicating the range. This is to control the dispersion of the process, standard deviation from the mean. So these two charts must be used together. X bar chart, R chart, sample mean, and sample standard deviation. So, there are two ways, the two situations. One is the when we know the standard deviation sigma, or when we do not know the standard deviation, but most cases we do not know standard deviation. So we assuming that we do not know standard deviation, we are using this formula for upper control limit and lower control limit for X bar chart. So sample mean plus A2 times R bar, range bar. And the lower control limit equals the sample mean minus the mean of the sample mean, actually, minus A2 times the average range of samples. So what the A2? A2 is the control chart factor coming from the this charted factor. So this factor table will be given. This is based on the 3 sigma level, because 3 sigma is the standard quality level we use to this. You have to know the sample size. Sample size, once you know the sample size, that will lead you to A2, which is a factor score. And then D3, D4 are used to measure the R chart. For example, if we know the process average of mean of the sample mean, average of sample mean, and the average value, range value, and then sample size n, then we are able to find out the upper control limit and lower control limit for X bar chart. This is to test and control the central tendency of the process. And this A2 comes from, you know, factor table based on the sample size N5. And this mean is the sample mean, which is process average, the average of sample mean 12, and upper control limit based on this formula we find that 12.144 ounce, and the lower control limit is the 11.857 ounce. And the R chart is the shows the sample range over time. Since we do not know standard deviation, we use the range value, which can be calculated as maximum value minus minimum value in the sample. So I will show you, through the kind of, problems. This will monitor the process variability. So X bar chart tests the sample mean, and R chart tests the control the process variability. The upper control limit can be found through D4 times R bar, which is the average value of range, and the lower control limit is D3 times R bar. So this D3, D4, as I said, can be found through factor table based on the sample size. In this case, they look at the average range R bar is 5.3, and then sample size is 5. So we find the D4 from the factor table based on the sample size 5, 2.115, D3 is 0. So upper control limit for R chart is the 11.2, lower control limit for R chart is 0 pound. And mean is the average range, is 5.3. So I will use these two problems using Excel spreadsheet in the next video clip. Okay? Thank you.